Nathan Oakley, him again, keeps on repeating his nonsense about not being able to measure an elevation angle from a curved adjacent or requiring a flat earth to establish your position using celestial navigation or not getting a right angle on a globe. He still doesn't understand that the measurement of an elevation angle can be made independent of the surface you are standing on. In fact, he doesn't understand the workings of celestial navigation in the first place, and on top of that, his whole argument is a red herring anyway. You don't need an elevation angle for celestial navigation, nor do you need a triangle, nor any trigonometry. You don't even need a sextant. You can use a sextant, and in that case you have to correct your measurements for refraction and dip to the horizon, but you can navigate without it. The only thing you need is a watch and a zenith angle. A watch, well, everybody has a watch, and a zenith angle you can measure directly without establishing a horizontal plane first. The only thing you need is an inclinometer. I made one in about 20 minutes. It took a little bit longer to make it such that I could register the observation. Flurfers don't accept any evidence without it being shown them in a video. So this is the thing. If you place it on a flat horizontal surface, you can look through the tube and aim it at a star of choice. Because I made this video indoors, I aimed it at the red star attached to the wall opposite the inclinometer. Now you can read off the zenith angle directly as being 70 degrees. The nice thing about it is that the zenith angle is measured from the vertical, in this case a small plumb bob. No matter what the direction of the surface you are standing on, be it a slope or a curved surface, the reading to the star always stays the same. Of course, it is a somewhat crude reading, but as you can see, the magnitude of the measured angle is more or less the same, independent of the initial position of the inclinometer. The next thing you have to do is repeat this measurement to two other stars and register the exact time you made your observations. And the only thing you have to do now is to go to a website, in this case onlinebacon.github.io, and enter your data. This site draws for you the circles of equal altitude, and at the crossing of the three circles you find your current position. Notice that these circles of equal altitude are only circles when drawn on a globe. The moment they are drawn on a projection of a globe, be it a Mercator projection, the equirectangular projection, the Gall-Peters projection, or even the AE projection, the map of choice of most flat earthers, the circles must be distorted in order to give the right outcome. That is because you cannot have a projection based on a globe that has no serious distortions. By the way, the determination of the position using these other three measurements was found within 4 minutes from the moment MC Toon opened up his sextant challenge to Globus using just this website. There was no flat earther who managed to do it, not even after 7 weeks. Notice also that the distance to the GP of the star to the observer is calculated using the 60 nautical miles per degree formula. In my previous video I demonstrated that this formula cannot work on a flat earth. The formula is simply derived from a circle with a radius of 6371 kilometers and a circumference of 2 times pi times the radius equals 40,030 kilometers. This measure represents 360 degrees of the circle, so 1 degree represents 111.19 kilometers. 1 kilometer equals 0.54 nautical miles, so 1 degree equals 60 nautical miles. This formula can only work on a globe with a radius of 6371 kilometers and with stars at a great distance. And it works every day, everywhere. Not on a flat Earth, mind you, only on a spherical Earth.